welcome back to my channel. My name is Austin Betha. If today is the first time here, you are most definitely welcome. Please do hit the subscribe button before you leave, and also give this video a very big thumbs up at the end if you enjoy watching it, okay? Look, today I'm not here to talk about Big Brother. I'm not here to talk about Tacha. I'm not here to talk about Mercy, Shay. Look, that's not the point of this video, alright? I'm just here to talk to you guys about some of the ultimate love couples. I'm aware that I abandoned those people for way too long because Big Brother started and I'm like, you know what? Damn ultimate love. But look, today I'm here with some news, okay? I know some of you might have even seen it, but then again, let me just do it. Let me do it to fulfill unrighteousness. Let me do it to satisfy my conscience. Alright? Now, as you guys know, some of the couples have obviously been bagging some deals in the past. Maybe it's not a lot of deals, but again, half bread is better than none. Today, I'm going to be mentioning some of the couples that recently bagged some deals. And of course, this whole rumor of Bola ship sinking. Okay? Before we get into this whole Bolale and Anon story, let's just go through the names of the couples and, you know, the brand that signed them and all of that. I have that in my notes, so I'm just going to read it out to you guys. Okay? Now, for Kachi and Rosie, Get Fit NG actually sign them as their ambassadors. Of course, you know what Get Fit NG is about. If you do not, please check them out on Instagram because I'm not here to run ads for them. But basically, what they do is they help you burn your belly fat. You know, I think they have like a waist trainer and stuff like that. Better, you've still done the advert. But anyways, that's what Get Fit is about, alright? For Presh Tucker and David Wilson, they were signed to Tech Vibes Limited. Now, Tech Vibes is a technology solutions company. I'm sorry, I don't know anything about technology, so maybe you should just go to the page and check it out. But I'm really happy for them. I think this is their first deal. I'm not sure, guys, let me know if they've signed any other deal before this one. Just let me know in the comment section, okay? Next on, we have Micheri, and this one was actually brought to my notice by my darling sister. As much as she's not even here with me, she still sources for news for me and sends it to me. So this is me saying thank you to her. I love you so much, okay? Anyways, Micheri was signed to Charisma Cosmetics, you know, and of course, by the name, you already know what they do. You know, they have all these cosmetic things. If you don't know what cosmetic things are, just go on the handle. Now, Cherry, as an individual, was signed to a fitness brand called the Ultimate Body Slim Product. Of course, you guys know how much Cherry loves to work out during the show, so it's not surprising at all that a fitness brand will sign her on and all of that. Now, for Chris Gayle, she was actually signed to Kayla Beauty. Of course, Kayla Beauty, all these cosmetic things and all. So yeah, I'm really happy for these people. Now, the reason I'm rushing like this is, number one, I need to step out of this house. Number two, I just want to get to the Bolale and Arnold story. Now, I want to say a very big congratulations to these couples that I mentioned. Guys, if you know any of the other love guests that have been signed to any particular brand or whatsoever, please let me know in the comment section as well. Alright, congratulations to you guys once again. Now, to Bolale and Arnold. Guys, what's going on? What is going on? I understood from the show that Jerry and Meriton were never going to work because, again, they did not really gel like that. Maybe in the beginning, it was just out of, there was nobody else to pick, so let me just be with her, let me just be with him. So it's actually not a surprise to me that outside of the house, it did not work. But for Bolale and Arnold, guys, I did not know that they were actually going to break up. Of course, I understood the fact that they had their issues. I know that Bolale can be really hot-headed, like she doesn't listen. Arnold also had his own wahala. In fact, I didn't really like the way he treated Bolale during the show at some point, okay? But when they came out of the show, you know, they were doing really well. I mean, because of the lockdown, you guys know that most of the couples were paired together in their hotel rooms and all of that, so they were putting out content and stuff like that, and it almost seemed like, oh, everything was fine up until Bolale had that breakdown. You guys remember that her famous breakdown that made it to Instablog Naija, you know, where she was crying and just saying people should stop. There was actually this particular person she was attacking because it seemed like the person was telling her, you know what, you're getting old, you need to just get married to Arnold right away. In fact, you need to get pregnant for him now that you guys are together in the same space and all of that. What are you waiting for? You're getting old, your time is passing and stuff like that. And that kind of got to her, like, why would you tell me to get pregnant for someone that I'm not even sure that the relationship is going to work? And in that particular life video where Bolale was ranting, Arnold kept on telling her it's okay, it's okay. He was trying to take the camera from her, but again, Bolale, we know, would just not stop until she has gotten everything out of her mind. And Bolale was like, look, the only reason I'm even in the same room with Arnold is because the organizers of the show placed us there because of the lockdown. If not, I would have moved over to my house and he would move over to his house. That it's bad enough that she doesn't even like that idea that they are cohabiting together and someone is trying to shove marriage down her throat. You know, she feels like she still needs some time to get to know the guy. I mean, when they were in the house, there were cameras everywhere, and she feels like now that they're outside, she needs to take her time to know the guy and stuff like that. And in my mind, I'm like, okay, it's a work in progress, and we're willing to wait till, you know, when that happens. Only for Cherry to make a post last night. Now, when I read that post, I was like, wow, is Cherry trying to tell us now that Bolale and Arnold are no more together? Like, I was really confused. Now, let me just read out the post to you guys. Okay, Cherry posted a picture of herself and then her caption read, "Dear Ultimate Love NG Male Love Guest, if you know that the amazing lady you coupled up with in the love pad isn't right for you, or it was just a game for you. Please, bros, the show is over. And it's not mandatory to continue whatever sick, selfish game you're playing with somebody's daughter. Be like Jerry and Arnold. Man up, be honest, and free the lady instead of occupying space meant for a genuine man. If na the fame, I think you all already have that to some extent though. Quit before it's too late. Thanks, yours sincerely, Dr. Cherry. Guys, let me just tell you, when I finished reading this, I just knew that that had to be true because, again, Cherry would not put up something she's not sure about. You guys know she's also close to Bolanle, so there's really no way she would make such posts when she doesn't really have facts. So it just means that Bolanle and Arnold are, they're done, okay? So it's not working. And let me tell you guys, there's nothing wrong with that, okay? Just because you guys were a couple during the show doesn't mean you have to remain a couple outside of the show. I've said this before on this channel. If you've been following me, you will know that today is not the first time I'm mentioning it. To be honest, Arnold and Bolanle had their issues. And there was a point where everybody just felt like, you know what, Arnold doesn't even deserve Bolanle and all of that. You know, people were really against Arnold. Some people even attacked me here when I posted the video where Arnold was apologizing to Bolanle and her fans. But for me, I wasn't really supporting Arnold. I was just bringing you guys the news. I was just telling you guys, oh, look at what Arnold is doing. He's actually apologizing. Maybe he has realized his wrongs and he's willing to make things work. But then again, I feel like they tried and it did not work. And that's okay. If they've truly moved on from one another, I know that they will definitely find people that they like, you know, people that they want to settle with. Look, there's really no such thing as, oh, time is going, you know, as a girl, you are getting old. Look, we're not going to now rush into things because time is running, okay? When my time reach, it reach. When your time reach, marry. You know, nobody should put any pressure on anybody because again, marriage is a two-way thing. Look, I cannot just go and marry somebody because everybody's like, oh, time is running, oh, you are getting old. That's not how it works. I'm going to wait till I find the person that is right for me. So it's very important that people understand this and just respect boundaries, okay? Just because they put their lives out there, just because now they are celebrities in quotes, doesn't actually give people the right to now tell them what to do and dictate who they should be with. This is their life. The game is over, okay? Ultimate love is over. In fact, don't forget them. We don't do Big Brother Naija. You guys, so it's really important that they do things that make them happy, genuinely. Alright, that's my own quota, guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Do you agree with the things I have said? If not, let me know why in the comment section as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to give me a very big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed. And I will definitely see you guys on the next one. Bye!